Hello everybody, welcome back to a new class. I hope you are doing great and you are more than ready to learn something new today. Okay, as usual, we start by making some brainstorming. Okay, so you guys tell me, what can you remember about last class? I give you a couple of seconds. What can you remember? What did we study last class? Let's see, let's figure it out. Post office, okay? Post office. We studied the whole vocabulary regarding this place, the place where you go to mail letters, mail boxes, and receive letters and boxes as well, okay? So let's see. Let's see how much you remember about this. I guess you remember this question. What are you doing in the post office? What are you doing in the post office? Tick-tock, tick-tock. Okay, I'm gonna give you a couple of examples about what to say. Buying stamps. If I ask you, what are you doing in the post office? Buying stamps. Or wrapping a box. What else? Buying stamps. Writing postcards or mailing a letter. Okay, but today we are going to concentrate more on the question, because that vocabulary was studied last class. Okay, today we concentrate on the question, and I guess you recognize these WH question words, right? We have what, where, and who. Las dos primeras ya hemos trabajado con ellas anteriormente. Quizás la que es nueva, la que nos resulta nueva en esta oportunidad, es la última palabra interrogativa, cuya pronunciación es who. Who. A veces los estudiantes tienden a confundirse o tienden a pronunciarlo incorrectamente. Dicen wow o wow. No, the pronunciation is who, como una J con U, who. Okay, entonces what significa qué y pregunta entonces por un objeto, por una cosa. Where, su significado es dónde y pregunta por un lugar. Lugares que ya hemos estudiado anteriormente, ya sabemos una lista de lugares como swimming pool, school, library, post office, okay. Y la última palabra interrogativa, desde la que les estaba hablando, who, pues esta la utilizamos para preguntar por una persona. ¿Cuál es el significado entonces? ¿Quién? Si yo digo, ¿quién se comió la torta? Bueno, tengo que responder con el nombre de una persona. Tengo que indicar una persona, ¿ok? So, let's see some examples with these WH question words. We are going to start with where. For example, where is he going? Where is he going? Here we have an example. He's going to the post office. He's going to the post office. Second example, where is she going? Okay, in this case, we are talking about a girl. For that reason, we use the personal pronoun she. Where is she going? She's going to the post office. She's going to the post office. Okay, tenemos dos ejemplos. ¿A dónde va él? Él va a tal lugar. Fíjense que esa palabra al final, post office, es un lugar, ¿verdad? La oficina postal. Yo puedo fácilmente intercambiarlo por otro lugar, como park. He's going to the park. He's going to the school. He's going to the supermarket. He's going to the cinema. Fácilmente puedo utilizar otro lugar, ¿ok? Esa palabra es completamente reemplazable. Second example, ok, well, as I told you before, we use where for the different, for asking about different places, such as castle, cinema, hospital, library, museum, park, restaurant, shop, station, and swimming pool. Ok, cada vez que veamos La palabra interrogativa where, ya saben que me está preguntando por un lugar. Yo tengo que responder con cualquiera de estos lugares que vemos acá. Then we have what. Yes, and this is demanding for an action. What is he doing? What is he doing? He's wrapping a box. He's wrapping a box. What is she doing? What is she doing? She's going to the post office. She's going to the post office. We continue and we have the last WH word, who. Who is it for? Okay, esta es la nueva palabra interrogativa. ¿Para quién es? ¿Para quién es esto? Who is it for? Yo tengo que responder con un lugar, con una persona, mejor dicho. It is for Adam. It is for Adam. Es para Adam. Second example. Who is it for? ¿Para quién es esto? Supongamos que tenemos un objeto. Who is it for? It is for Mary. It is for Mary. O sea, todo lo que tenemos que hacer, chicos, en esta oportunidad es practicar estas preguntas, esta conversación. Puede ser con mi hermano, puede ser con mi papá, puede ser usted solo. Usted hace la pregunta, usted responde. No tiene nada de malo, ¿ok? Incluso puede darle unas lecciones a su papá y demostrarle sus conocimientos hasta el momento. También sería bastante interesante, ¿verdad? Ok. Bueno, well, that's all, guys. I hope you have a great weekend. And I see you guys next week. Bye bye and take care.